What kind of ship is it?
I don't know if the Spiegel Grove is aircraft carrier or if that's the Vandy. I'm getting confused. But one's like a giant aircraft carrier and one's like a destroyer.
Oh, wow.
Huge. 500 feet. Yeah, they're sunk. They're natural reefs. So the government sunk them, you know, cut a bunch of holes in them for idiots like me to go swim through.
Oh, they sunk them on purpose.
Oh, yeah. So they take all the fluids out of them, they sink them, and they make them artificial reefs.
Wow. And so they do this because they decommissioned the ship.
Correct.
And they don't know what to do with them. So they say this is a good move.
Let's let fish and wildlife hang out. And then they make money off guys like me, like, hey, let's go fucking explore this thing.
You have to pay to go there?
No, you just pay for the gas. But the thriving boat captain that needs to feed his family charges you $180 to take you out with the GPS and tell you good luck.
Wow.
So me and Lindsay are out there. Well, of course, I'm seeing cool shit because I'm down in the engine room fucking doing whatever I want. And she gets tangled up and has like a freak out episode. And then I come back like, what the fuck? You gave her like, where you been? And she's like, motherfucker, like all mad at me. Was all caught up in the thing. So I had to... When we got back up to the surface, I got my ass tore up. But, I was like, well, you made it. You're good. Like all the practice we did.
Walk it off.
Shit. Yeah. So.
Have you ever gone like on treasure hunting dives?
No. So first of all,
it's
I need
to
live near
the
ocean with
when you're hungry.
And second, I need to
know
somebody who has
Jack in the Box now delivers
and
through DoorDash.
You
can get all your favorites
captains,
delivered right to your door.
Fishing.
And get back to saving the world.
Because where the good fishing is usually there's a
delivery
structure
through
down,
the DoorDash.
Right? So that's how you
new,
run.
From
you
Jack
find
the
like
box.
An old boat captain and know like a structure that's not on anyone's GPS, then maybe you can dive down there and check it out. But you need, usually those are 250, 300 feet, so you need some guys that you trust to fucking go deep with you.
Yeah.
So, but no, I haven't. I would love to. That'd be something that I would fucking love to do.
I was watching this show. I don't remember what ocean they were pulling the wreck from, but these guys were professional treasure hunters, and they found some insane amount of gold, like some Roman ship that sank.
Could you imagine?
Yeah, and they were trying to figure out who gets the gold and who claims it.
Yeah, me. That's who it'd be. It'd be fucking go time.
But you have to be, like, really careful about, like, giving out the location because other treasure hunters would find it. Like, there's a big business in that shit.
Well, so, like, let's just say me and you go treasure hunting and the captain takes the spot. We find it. We jump down. Also, we find all this gold and this treasure.
Right.
We only have enough gas for, who knows, 20 minutes down there.
Right.
So we got to come back up. We couldn't even bring the fucking gold this trip if we wanted to.
Right.
So now we're back in the boat. You know, I know, the boat captain knows who else is with us. So now we got to figure out, who do we tell?
Right.
And do we tell this boat captain, you're coming with us for the next, till we figure this shit out, because I'm not going to let you go tell us whoever you,
Yeah, man, that gets really, really tricky. You have to kill the captain.
You would have to. You'd have to.
Well, do you know how to use a GPS?
Yeah,
you know,
I mean,
like,
I think nowadays
drop
you just
a
press
pin.
The button, right? Drop a pin, yeah.
Yeah, you'd have to drop a pin, and then you have to kill that guy and drop him where the pin is. Or don't kill him. You got to cut him in. He's got to get a third.
Something. Yeah. Or
depends on
third.
Yeah, how much money
you're
talking
about.
But then
is it fair that he gets a third for, you're talking probably millions of dollars.
Yeah, but if you don't give him a third, he's going to fuck you.
He's going to rat. He's going to fuck you.
Yeah, you have to give him a third. Because you got to think, if he didn't take you there, you'd have never got it. And it's a shitload of money. It's free. And it's
so if he says half, then what do you do?
Fuck you. Then you kick his ass. Like, you don't let him get half. You got to be generous, but if he tries to fuck you on your generosity, that's when you kill him.
Oh, man.
How many people have probably been killed over shipwrecks and
yeah, pirates? Pirate shit? Yeah, that goes back.
A lot.
Yeah.
You think about those shitty-ass wooden boats, how many of those fucking things must have crashed? Plus those greedy bitches, they loaded them up with gold, tried to make it across the ocean.
Yeah, plus if I was a pirate, I'd be known when you're loading yours up, and I'd just go fucking take yours over and take all. So now I got all my shit plus all your shit.
Right.
Plus we found another one on the way, so now I'm tripled up. Big heavy boat.
Well, this documentary that I was watching, this guy who was doing it was a professional treasure hunter. That's what he does. And, you know, he has to get investors involved because it costs hundreds of thousands of dollars to make millions of dollars treasure hunting, and then you got to be able to find them. A lot of them are apparently around Florida.
ISIL.
Sure. Well, that's so, like, Key West, there's so many, like, wrecked ships because that was, like, the port. You know,
that was
so, yeah, I could only, I mean, I went to, they have, like, a wrecked ship museum, and I went in there and talked to all the guys in there, and they were saying that, man, there's thousands and thousands of boats that are all, because that's the port where they would do all the trading. Thousands.
Wow. It's a whole other fucking world down there, man. Well, it really
just
is.
Just like the Little Mermaid, it's a whole new world. But
a whole new world. That's it. Look, I have kids, man. I've heard that fucking song.
Oh, yeah, we all have.
We were just at the Seattle Aquarium, and I was looking at these octopuses. They had this octopus exhibit, and they were doing this thing on octopuses where this lady was explaining they have three hearts. And
it's insane.
And the brains are on their neck. And
underwater is fucking... like, yeah, if you're a scuba diver and you haven't done a night dive, because it's a whole nother world at night, like the what are the when you move...
Luminescence.
Yeah. Crazy. Yeah, you can move underwater and everything glows, and... the octopus, how fast they change colors and move.
So when you move underwater, you glow?
Oh, yeah. If you shut all your lights off, when you just like move your arms and draw, like you could write Joe, and you just spell out in the So cool.
Why is that? Why can you see it? What is it?
I think the shrimp.
Phytoplankton. I've seen this
the plankton.
Puerto Rico.
Oh.
Here you go. Whoa. Look at this. Look at this.
That's insane.
So cool. I mean, that might be a little bit digitally fixed, but... it's fucking cool.
Wow. Yeah. So what area of the world is this stuff
well,
in?
Well, we do it in Cozumel whenever I go down to Mexico, so wow. I'm sure it's...
yeah, they have it in Puerto Rico. That's where I've seen it. In like
it's unbelievable. So you go down there, shut your lights up, and you can just play in the water and kick up and make... they just glow. It's write your name. Yeah.
Wow. That's like spaceship.
It is spaceship. And then you have these crazy octopuses that can change colors. I don't even know how many different colors they can change, but you just see them fucking crawling all across the ground. It's insane. Cool.
Wow. Yeah. That is so bizarre. And these thousands of ships that they, like, one day they're going to figure out technology to go and find those things. They're going to be able to locate all of them. But right now,
Wooden, so they're rotting away. So there's not much left of them, right? So I mean, the metal ships are the only thing. I've done one wooden, and it was shit. It was, like, all falling apart, you know?
Yeah, they don't find much, but what's left
back,
is, like,
missed.
The pottery.
Pretty much the whole wave.
The gold.
I am so at the bottom of the scoreboard.
You guys are garbage. To find some certain metal things.
You step it up.
But, like, swords rot away.
Or not to mention dead bodies.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're finding a ship that no one's ever seen, there's
Captain Cook.
Right?
Yeah, turns out I'm lazy. I know, my fingers are too, bro.
Yeah, talk about putting your heartbeat through the roof, going, opening a hatch, and just seeing... skeleton head fall in your lap.
Did you ever see that boat that they found that was adrift, and there was a dude who had turned into, essentially, he had turned into a mummy.
And he got some fire checks.
He had been mummified by the sea air and dried out, slumped over the table. Like, he had a table in the galley, and he slumped over the table, and he's dead. There he is. That's how they found that dude.
Well, because I feel like that's...
bump it, bro. Come on.
That's the same movement anyone's going to do when you're on your last leg. Yeah. When you're in a boat. That's I'm fucking sick, and that's the move you're going to do.
It's raining, says, mummy found on boat missing since 2009.
It's raining cash. And there he is. One leg out. Poor one leg out posted.
He's like, I guess this is
this
it.
This is it.
Damn. I wonder if another person would have made it. I wonder if he was a pussy.
Take these grenades and cash those.
I wonder if he gave out.
I mean,
you know, got tired of fishing. I can't do it.
Well, it's probably it's the fresh water that would get you.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sure you could eat, catch fish, you know, it'd be
take
the, it'd
me,
be the water that would get you.
Yeah.
So you how long can
piss.
You?
How long can you drink your piss?
I personally know I could go a week without water from my cuts of 155, so I know I could do a week.
Yeah.
And that'd be, after that, I'm on my deathbed.
Yeah, dude, let's talk about that. Don't do that anymore, man. I know you keep talking about, like, fighting Eddie Alvarez because you already beat him and now he's the champ, but God damn, you're looking good at 170.
Yeah, but so, you're saying I didn't look good at 55.
You looked sensational at 55.
I went 9 for
but
10.
But at 170,
and
you're
my
a
last
fucking
run.
World beater, man. It's not just that you look good. It's just the way you look. It's like you hit a whole new level, and I always wonder, like, is it because obviously you keep training, obviously you keep getting better, obviously you work hard. All those things, learning from experience, all those things are a factor. But on top of that, there's also the factor of you not having to cut that fucking weight, man.
So this last fight.
Against Rick Story. Well, it looked like you were in the fucking Matrix. That was some Anderson Silva shit.
I ate five guys. Three nights that we were in Vegas.
Five Guys burgers?
Burgers, hamburgers.
Good man.
Doubles.
I'm a big fan of those. Did you get jalapenos on those?
Of course. Yeah, you get the jalapeno. get the season fries.
Of course.
Yeah. I mean, so
yeah, see, you're all healthy.
My trainers are happy. Yeah, I mean, I think I had 6 pounds to cut. It was an easy.
Yeah.
No brainer. Yeah.
Well, when I saw you before the fight, before that, you were a 176 when you were at the Comedy Store.
Yeah.
That's nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah. Look how good you look at this weight.
I feel good. That's for damn sure.
But isn't that a factor? I mean, look how fast you are. Like the Cote fight, dude, you were on fire. You're on fire at that weight.
Yeah.
I don't know. What's the thought process?
Like,
you can do 155, right? You can do it. You have
I wish it was like 60 or 65. If it was 65 weight class, that'd be Cowboys weight class. But it's just that last 5 pounds is death for me. It's fucking brutal. You know, from 60 to 55, I just feel like I got nothing left, man. I don't know if that carries over. Like I want to ask, you see Pettis looked a little tired, didn't he, in his last fight? I don't know if the 45 cut, if that has something to do with it.
Oh, for sure.
If it takes a little bit of your gas tank a little bit.
100%. 100%. It has to. It has to. Right?
Yeah, I feel great out there.
That's what I'm saying.
I fucking love fighting, man. It's like my favorite thing in the whole world to do. Like, in the whole world. Like, I wish a motherfucker when I leave here pulls up in the parking lot and tries to get some shit. Like, that to me is like, you know? And this is what is the craziest thing to me. People tell me, like, I post pictures of me flipping people off, right? So they're like, Cowboy, you're a fucking role model. How dare you? Like, no, I'm not. I'm a bar junkie that fights all the time, and you guys, it's now on TV, and you think it's cool, so I'm your favorite fighter, you know? But had you not been in the UFC, I'd be the asshole trying to take your girlfriend and fight you at the bar, just so you know. You know, that's who I would be.
Just so you know. You know, just so you know.
But
you say that, but you're a very nice guy. I've seen you out there in public, and part of it is because you're dealing with people that are fans, and you know, they come up to you, they're nice.
I'm just saying, I love fighting, man. It's like,
you love it also because you're really good at it. I mean, if you kept getting your ass kicked, you'd be like, man, I gotta find some other shit to do in my life.
Like when I was in high school and like figuring out who I was, I got my ass kicked a lot because I was that guy. Like it didn't ever take much for me to jump, you know, and I'd strike, and then I'd get my fucking ass mopped by three dudes, two dudes, one, didn't matter. I'd just get beat up.
And that's what got you into MMA?
No, I started off kickboxing. A buddy of mine just told me, you think you're tough, come try this kickboxing shit, and I went down and fell in love with it, and 2 weeks
Where'd
later.
Where'd you train? Where's the first place you trained?
Commerce City Rec Center in Commerce City, Denver. It's like it was this rec center that offered Taekwondo Tuesdays and Thursday nights. And I'd go in there and we'd spar. And sparring is all I did. Like, that's what I used to do. Like, I thought that was getting ready for a fight would just be fucking throwing down. Now I don't spar at all. And all I do is drill, because drilling is the most important thing you do, right? But that's all I would do is spar. And
so you don't spar at all
now?
That's really interesting.
No, I tell my training partners and everyone that try to get me to spar, but now they're okay with me just drilling. But I feel like the little guy at the Walmart check-in clicking. Every time you take a hit to your head, he pushes the button. How many people go into Walmart before it's full? I don't know.
Yeah.
I have no idea. How many more do I got?
I think that's a very good point.
How many epic fucking brawls do me and Leonard Garcia have in the training room? Yeah. I don't know.
Right.
So, I'll get in there and move around with Andre and move around with all the heavyweights. But, like, light. MMA sparring, you know, heavy takedowns and grappling, real light striking, you know. But the days of putting the big gloves on and throwing down, hell no. I just did it with Joe Schilling the other day, so I can't really say hell no. But him and I had a good tempo, and it wasn't anything crazy, you know.
I watched videos of you guys sparring. It seemed very controlled.
Very controlled. So that if I'm sparring with someone that's very controlled and doesn't try and kill me, cool. But, man, going in with some of those guys that are trying to make a name at the gym, just want to crank you. Then I got to fuck him up. You know what I mean? Now we're fighting. And,
That's a funny contradiction. It's like, I love to fight, I don't want to spar.
Yeah. I love to fight, but I don't want to get hit anymore. Is there any way we could do that?
These beers say America on them.
They say America. That's what I said. That's the new thing.
Is this the new thing that Budweiser does?
Yeah.
America. That's interesting. How do you not buy those if you see those in the store?
I don't know.
It's a good move. What if Coors comes along and goes, America, fuck yeah.
We don't even talk about Coors. We talk about ice cold refreshing Budweisers. That's what we do.
Oh, that's it?
That's what we talk about.
Oh, because they're your sponsor?
Yeah.
That's
like On It. We don't talk about Muscle Farm products. We just talk about,
We can talk about Muscle Farm products. I don't give a fuck. I'm the least competitive guy ever.
I hear it.
I'm a supporter.
So, I love fighting, man. I mean, to
my
soul.
I like the fact that you don't spar. I think that's very wise. Now, when you're doing drills, like, explain to me how you're doing them. Like,
okay.
Are you setting everything up from a striking standpoint, where like you work in combinations and then counters to those combinations and then possibilities of all the different things that could happen.
Yes, I'm working with Brandon Gibson now. You know, he's a fucking great tactician, man.
Big fan of that guy.
Yeah, he breaks the break. So I don't ever watch tape. People think that's so crazy, but I don't. I just don't. But they do. So my coaches do. So he'll come and he'll be like, "This is we're working this because I think this is what Story's going to do." You know, we knew he's going to come with big overhands and the knees of the body were going to be there. So everything we drill is, you know, when he does this, it's just make it reactionary, you know? And I feel like that's all good and great, but the good thing is I know how to fucking fight, like, deep down in my soul. So if everything, all that doesn't work, I can just fucking bite down and give her.
Yeah, well, you know, Jeremy Stevens had a very similar sentiment. He said, "I already know how to fight."
Yeah.
Yeah, he goes, "It's all about just getting prepared, working on my cardio, working on my fitness, working on my drills and my techniques."
Yeah. And that's, I'm 1,000%. I mean, I don't ever take days off. Like today, of course, taking off and drinking beer with you. But, I mean, for the most part, I train probably 5 days a week. And a lot of people think that all I do is fuck off. Like, he just drinks beer and parties. And no, I just don't post pictures of me training because I fucking hate that. I hate I see everyone else's photos. Like, them in the gym. Them, 6 posts a day of them working. Like, no one gives a fuck. You swim, you strength conditioning, you, like, whatever. So I just do cool shit and throw that on Instagram, you know? But I train all the time. Like, it's like my job, you know? So people always think I'm out there fucking off, but I mean, I take this very serious and I train hard. And
there's no way you could be as good as you are without.
Yeah, I mean, I have a gym in my backyard. So some days I'll go play at the lake all day, but we come home and then we train. And my coach is like, "Fuck, now it's 2 a.m. and we have to train." So,
right.
I mean, it's just, but I love it.
Did you make the decision to stop sparring?
Probably 4 fights ago. Yeah.
Which fight?
After I got my ass whipped by Alvarez or by
Dos Anjos?
Dos Anjos. Yeah, I didn't spar that camp much at all. But, yeah, I don't know. I talked to Aubrey, that's how I got hooked up with Onnit, man. I started thinking something was fucked up with my brain. So I start brushing my teeth one morning, and I fall over and I hit the wall. Like, I literally fell over and, like, hit my shoulder on my wall. And I was like, "What the fuck?" And I closed one eye, and I fell over and hit the other wall. And I was like, "Oh, man, something's wrong." You know, like, something's seriously wrong with my brain. And I start freaking out. So I go get a CAT scan. I go get an MRI. And I'm convinced that I'm concussed and that I've taken too many shots. And I'm
First side.
It's because, so what, let me back the story up a little bit. Why I think this is because my buddy Scott Parker, he's the enforcer for the Colorado Avalanches. He can no longer take, he has like a problem with his brainstem. He's took too many punches. Doctor said if he takes one more, it's going to kill him, right? So I'm like, talking to him about this, and now he's like got it in my mind that I had the same thing. Like, I'm thinking, like, I fall over, like, literally fall over, hit the wall. I'm like, "Oh, fuck, something's really fucked up with me." Anyways, I go get all these tests, go see a ear, nose, and throat doctor, and it turns out my septum's so deviated that I have like a sinus infection and that it can't drain because my septum's deviated. So I have like this serious infection in my left cheek. And I had to get this. I had to get on medication to get it cleared up. But that's why it fucked my equilibrium up. I was like,
so it's getting in your ear?
Yeah, it like
they're all connected.
Yeah,
right?
The infection somehow through my. I have no idea. I know how to put this. I still have to do it every day. I got to put this thing in my nose and like blows like a nasal spray in my nose.
Get your shit fixed.
God,
get
I need to.
I got mine.
But then
fixed.
I had to stop fighting for a little while.
Nah, not that long. Not that long, man. I'm telling you.
It turns out I'm not mentally retarded. I have an infection that I got cleared up, which is what I contacted you and I told Aubrey about, and the CMT oils and the MCT oils and the Alpha Brain and started trying to, because this is the point where I thought I was fucking freaking out, right?
Well, you started taking care of your health and supplementing.
And now I feel fucking great, man.
Yeah, there's a big difference between supplementing and not supplementing.
And I've never taken anything. I just never, everyone always, I was literally Budweiser and Fruit Roll-Ups, you know? And
I know, we talked about it.
And now I fucking take these Onnit packs day and night, sometimes 2 a day. I feel fucking, you know what I feel like? A fucking caged gorilla that's 15-year-old. And I don't know if it has testosterone or not, but I feel like my poor girl is just ravaged now. Like, I feel like an uncaged beast, man.
I'm sure she's happy.
Yeah, she's very happy. So, you know, and I don't know if it's because it just equaled out my body or what, but man, I feel my recovery time's
great.
Stuff
and
I'm not
taking?
Here just pumping on it, you know? I've never taken supplements and I feel so fucking good. And I right when I walked out, I said, "Hey man, you got any Alpha Brain here I can fucking pop?" You know? And so,
are we out? Do we have some?
There's out. You're out.
Damn it.
But
I must have some in my bag.
So yeah, it's unbelievable, man, how good I feel and how you don't know till you know, right?
Right. Yeah, that's the key, man. The key is a lot of people walk around and they don't take anything and they think they don't need anything. And they're like, I'm fine. But you're fine.
Yeah.
Like you'll exist, but there's a big difference between having your body optimized and not being optimized. Healthy food, you got to get off the candy, son. Arby,
you know what?
To me about
I don't
candy
fucking
habit.
Eat candy anymore. Ever since I've been taking these pills, it's like it filled a void. Literally, I don't crave like the sweets like I used to. It's unbelievable, man. I can honestly say I've ditched the candy. I'm like I'll eat a Snickers bar every now and then, but I don't take handfuls of Milk Duds and Skittles like I used to every day.
I used to crash,
right?
Yeah.
And I feel like that's why I'd eat the candy to try and like
come back up.
But
yeah, definitely. Yeah. I'm sure. Are you taking probiotics now? Are you taking the total gut health?
Total gut health.
That's big because your gut health determines a lot of times what you crave. And one of the things that people find is when they get off sugar and they get off gluten, and they get off like simple carbohydrates, breads and pastas
so
and stuff like that.
What part of that makes me crave the pussy? Is that the...
That's natural.
Oh, natural.
That's your body's going, I'm a cowboy. I'm here to fuck.
Now that I'm equaled out? Okay, I got
you. The same part that makes you want to fight makes you want to fuck.
Gotcha.
It's a part of the whole gorilla DNA.
All right.
Yeah, no, are you taking T-plus? Do you take, that optimizes your hormones. That's a big one. There's Alpha Brain, which one of the good things about Alpha Brain is mental fatigue. One of the things that helps you in your workouts is, like, a lot of times, like, physical fatigue is one factor, but mental fatigue is a factor, too. Like, when you step up, even if your body's tired, if your mind feels good, you could force your body to go through the motions. You could force your body to do it because your mind still feels energetic. But when my mind feels shitty, like, for me, the hardest workouts by far are when I'm hungover.
Oh, yeah.
Because my mind is tired. It's like, it's not even like my body can't lift the weight. It's like my body's like, oh,
fuck
okay, we'll do it. Yeah. But my mind is like, I can't muster it. So Alpha Brain post drinking is fantastic. It's one of the best things for hangovers because a lot of things that are going on, you're dehydrated. That's a big factor. But also like all your electrolytes are all fucked up and all your neurotransmitter levels are all fucked up. You could jack those back up with Alpha Brain and New Mood. New Mood's a big one, too, because it brings up your serotonin levels, 5-HTP.
That comes in the night pack for sleeping, right?
Yeah.
Perfect.
And I tell people, oh, you're trying to sell Alpha Brain. Listen to me. Please don't buy it. Please don't buy it. Find out what the ingredients are. Go buy your own shit. Go buy it the best form you can buy. That's the most important thing. Buy the purest, best version of it you can find. Use all those things. Use choline. Use all these different ingredients that you're going to find in Alpha Brain and all the different ingredients you're going to find in New Mood. You're going to have results. But if you want to get it made for you in the best possible form, that's what we sell. That's what we're trying to do it on it. We're just trying to everything that I use, everything that Aubrey uses, everything that all the pro athletes use, guys like you use, we just find that what's the best shit.
Yeah.
What's the best shit?
I literally feel the best I've felt in my life, and I don't know if it has to do with solely taking on it or just reinventing myself, man. You know, you gotta sometimes just fucking step back and reset and figure out what works for you, right?
That's big.
Real big, and it took a lady, Francesca Parker, Scott's wife, to set me down and fucking tell me, Cowboy, what's the bad in your life? We gotta get that shit. We gotta get the energy vampires off you, and you gotta hone in and figure out what works for you again, man. And I did, and I feel fucking great, man.
Has Aubrey taken you into the room in his house for the launching into space?
No.
The psychedelic journey room?
No.
Are you ready for that?
I'm ready for that.
Are you ready for that?
I'm ready for that.
I'm ready for that too. I need to do it this year. I'm about a year off. I've done it. I did it about a year ago. I'm feeling like right about now I'm ready to get back in there. Let's do it together.
Okay.
Let's do it. Let's hook up with Aubrey. We'll figure out a time. We got to go meet the overlords. I'm telling you, man. All the shit that you say is crazy. I believe it's crazy, but it ain't crazy like DMT is crazy.
All right.
DMT is some next level crazy.
So you're
crazy.
Telling me, let's go do some drugs and hang out.
I'm telling you.
Is this USADA approved?
Yes.
Perfect.
It is.
All right.
Well, you can't test for it.
All right. So that is
the, and it exists in your own brain. It's like testing you for saliva.
All right.
Literally, it's like testing you for blood. Oh,
I'm in.
Cowboy test positive for red.
no! Fuck!